think Naveen is showing offline. So please take the remaining people introduction and then proceed.
What is people name?
Yeah.
Suresh, Naveen, Praveen.
Yeah. Yeah. And Paul also.
Okay. Mr. Paul, can you hear me? Hello? Hello?
Hello, Paul? Hello, Praveen?
Hi.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, hi. Can you hear me?
Can you able to hear? Suresh?
Yes, yes, yes. I'm able to hear you.
Hello, okay. Suresh? Hello, Suresh? Hello, Paul? Hello? 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 Yeah, right, I think. Hello? Yeah, Paul, can you able to hear? Hello, Praveen?
Yes, yes, I am able to hear you properly.
Yeah, yeah, Sheetal, please take his introduction. I think they will be also joined.
Okay, fine. Yeah, Mr. Praveen, before we start, can you give me some brief and background detail of yours, how you came to know about SAP, or you have some SAP experience?
I'm basically from Cochin, and I'm working for a captive BPO, and I got about 7 years experience in HR, and in my last organization, I was an end user for SAP HR. And I support
which module?
It is the personal administration module.
Personal administration, okay.
Hello. Yeah, Paul.
Then I like when I joined my last organization, they were going through the SAP implementation. So right from beginning to end, I supported the migration part. But again, I don't have any core in functional side. So my objective, and in my current organization also, they are planning to go SAP by next month. So my objective is to learn the basics so that I can support the implementation.
Fine, that's great. And we have Mr. Paul, can you hear me? Suresh, can you hear me?
Hello. Yeah. Hello. Yes, Sheetal. Hello, Sheetal. Yeah, Paul can able to hear. So you will, if you have any doubts, you
have to check
me.
If they're. Fine.
Right. You can continue the demo. I will call him once again.
What was the guy?
Yeah. Right.
Okay. Praveen.
Yes.
Praveen, can you hear me?
Yes, yes, I am able to hear you.
Regarding the demonstration.
Yeah, sure.
In case of any doubt, you just let me know.
I think pressed in mute button in your keyboard.
My name is Ashitananda. I have a 7+ year experience of SAP HR.
Okay.
I have done 2 implementation, 2 support, 2 upgradation, and now again I am into our implementation project.
Click on your mic.
I have worked with the project team, now I am working with the project manager.
Okay.
I am taking care almost all modules of SAP HR apart from that HCM modules, related modules like ESS, MSS. As you are aware of that ERP, so I'm just skipping this part. Like SAP is one of the ERP which is available in the market, like other ERPs like Oracle, PeopleSoft, JD Edwards, man. Why everyone is going for SAP implementation? Because SAP has 2 lakh plus customers worldwide. They are available in the 50 countries, and out of the 2 lakh customers, they have 80,000 plus from a mid-size enterprises only. So it's really easy to implement and easy to maintain software, and the support of this SAP is really nice. Matter in which country, in which industry you are going for tomorrow after doing this SAP HR or any of the SAP module, you can join any industry. You don't require that particular sector's knowledge. Like today you have maybe experience, you are working into a BPO. Tomorrow you can shift in a financial or maybe retail company or biometric or any pharmacy company. They will not ask you, okay, do you carry any telecom industry experience or not. If you know how to do the things in SAP, so that is same everywhere. Because what we are going to teach you is nothing new, nothing coding, programming related thing. Everything is already there in the SAP system. According to the client requirement, just we have to mold something and give to the client. So SAP. New version name is SAP HCM, Human Management. Apart from this, you can go for according to your industry requirement. Like if you want to automate sales and distribution, you can go for sales module. If you want to automate all the procurement of your company, you can go for MM module. Like that, finance and controlling, asset management. A lot of modules are available in the SAP. Now, this is the methodology strategy which we use throughout SAP career, which is nothing, just a 5 phases. How we start our SAP? It is common with every company. Now, if I'll teach you something, if I'll work with you, your organization, or you'll call anybody from Accenture or a Deloitte for or any of the channel partner of SAP, they'll also do the same work. How? We all are on the one benchmark because we follow SAP strategies, given practices, given theory only. So this is the way we start. First phase is a project preparation, where we decide the team decision, initial planning we'll do, project team we will create. Like I am from a maybe IBM channel partner of the SAP. You are a ABC company. You want to get implementation done in your company. So in it, I'll just talk about SAP HR. In HR department, you have maybe 50 or 100 employees. So I cannot come and teach you all people SAP. So what I'll do, I'll see what all you people are doing daily, weekly, monthly, annually, year-ending, closing, that all the day-to-day tasks and activities. And we will automate that into SAP. Plus, we will give you suggestions and new ideas that once we will be doing, implementation of yours. So that's really from your company also, that key persons who will give us the answers of whatever the question will put up. So that we call a core team. The person who's working in HR called end users. Core team, out of those end user only, will pick some company will give us some key persons who will give us the response and whatever the information we require. Second thing is a blueprint. This is the main phase where we do the documentation part, as is and to be. As is means we will gather all the information of your company, like give us a flow chart, give us your policies, your procedures, your letters, your workflows, your reporting, external reporting, what challenges do you execute, everything, all that Form 16, challenge, payslip, all hiring to leaving policy, leave policies, everything we will gather from you, and then we'll create a 1-2-B document. In that we will tell you how we'll give you. Like I'll give you one small example. Like already personal data form is available in the system. I'm sure you also have worked on that. Info type 2, where employee info, personal detail you can store, like his first name, middle name, last name. But as SAP works globally, so in that form, they have more than a expected options. Like you can store in that birth name, your second name, your nickname, your birth name, all this information as well. But maybe your company don't want to capture in their data your birth name, your nickname, or your second name. So what we have to do, being as the consultant, we'll hide those information. That's it. So like that, we do all the things here in the blueprint phase. This is just a small example of personal data. Maybe you are executing hundreds of reports, and in SAP we'll give you very few reports which can help you or execute the data of that 100 reports. Or we will customize the report, we will prepare the reports, and if something daily you want to execute, so no need to go for a mail merge and opening SAP or anything to do. We can create a report, we can schedule it every day morning, what time you need, it will be rich in your inbox. So this is the blueprint phase. After that called realization phase, here the configuration will happen. Like according to business blueprint, we will enable the SAP for the client. After fourth phase is a go live preparation, or you can say a final preparation. Here we do the regression testing. We also will do the testing, we'll give end user training, and that or the core team, we will give them a training. They will test all the scenarios weekly, annually, all the integration, all the interfaces, they'll test each and everything, and the end user will also test everything. After their sign off, their testing, their 100% results, will go for a go live. Go live is a data migration from non-SAP to SAP. Whatever the legacy data you have, will transfer all the employees' data. SAP HR is a one module of SAP, and SAP HR itself has so many modules. So as it is an initial training, this is a basic module which will be there with every company. Apart from this module, we have some advanced modules also available in the market, which you can alter or tailor your course content, or you can go for as well. So the model which is in front of me is like first module of SAP HR is organization management, then recruitment, personal administration, time management, payroll, and integration with FICO. Apart from this, we can have benefit module, compensation management, travel management, personal development, all this module, training and event management we can have. So all those module I have already worked on. Like tomorrow you don't want maybe time management and the payroll, you want to add benefit and compensation. So like that we can do. Apart from ESS MSS module, for which we have separate course curriculum. Now in deep into these modules, what is there inside modules? The module is organizational management, which will take care of organization hierarchy, your company hierarchy and your employee hierarchy. What is the meaning of the company hierarchy? Maybe you have a group company, then some sister companies, and thousands of the branches, locations, and departments, sub-departments. Employee means maybe on the top you have a chairman, then general manager, then deputy managers, and all accountant drivers. The way you have, we will automate your system here. We will create all that hierarchy in this system. Second module is a recruitment module, which will take care of applicant hunting till offer letter release. Like we will receive the vacancy from the business, we'll give the advertisement, we'll receive the application, we'll sort it out, we'll take their interview, we'll take the feedback of the managers, line managers, then we will update the master data of applicant, and after that we'll release offer letter. Once he will select or he will accept our offer letter, we'll go for our next module, which is personal administration. This is a heart of SAP HR. Like if you are applying for abroad and all, then after OM recruitment and PA module, you can apply for a job, because there we need a specialized person. This module is a heart of SAP HR, which will take care of a hiring till rehiring. This model is of a US one company, so it's not that this much only. like hiring, transfer, resignation, increment, decrement, warning, suspension, termination, leave with pay, leave without pay, retirement, rehiring. So according to your company policy, we'll give you everything. Here only we will maintain the master data of employee related to other modules also, like benefit, compensation, travel management. Every module's master data we will update here. So one consultant should know A to Z of this. Apart from this module, you can go for specialization. Like you can show your specialization in SAP PA module, or you can choose your time management or payroll. But one cannot handle all modules. That's a fact. Now, next module is a time management, which will take your leave policy, your holiday calendar, your public holiday calendar, your company holiday calendar, your shifts, your absences, your absences quota, your company leave policy, like you have a sick leave, privilege leave, casual leave, maternity leave, paternity leave, annual leaves, all that things we will maintain here, attendance, that integration of your biometric system, the way you punch in your company, that also will be connected here, and all the other things like compensation, your availability, your substitution, your overtime will all do in this module. Module is a payroll. You are from the coaching, right, Praveen?
Yes.
Okay, fine. This is for the US screen. In India, we have PF, we have ESI, we have LWF, we have a PTEX, we have all ATC deductions, we have all basic salary component, maybe flexible benefit components as well. We have net salary components, all the deductions of your company, bonuses, advances, we will all take care in this payroll model. This is a payroll cycle which is common for every company. Like we will create position in OM module, we'll hire employee in a PM module, we'll give all the inputs, we'll run the payroll, disburse the salary and post it to finance module. We just process the salary. We don't give them a payment by check or by bank transfer is a task of FI module, like a finance module only. This is there in SAP HR. Apart from this, yes, we have, I told you, so many other modules as well. So according to your interest, according to your company need, according to the market need, you can tailor your course as well. Like OM recruitment, PA is compulsory for everyone. After that, you can choose any of the two modules. So, any doubt, any question is in your mind? Related to training, related to documents, related to guidance, anything?
I can take the course online and I can grab the basic, but again, what about the practical training?
This is the practical training only. Like I'll share all the business scenario because I'm a real-time consultant only, so I don't have anything fake or dummy. So I'll be sharing all the real-time scenarios with you, and we will work only on SAP. We'll not work on maximum theory. We'll give you the theory to read. We'll guide you on the theory, but we will work. We will navigate SAP. Like if I'll talk about PM module, so as an end user, you might have worked on hiring action, transfer action, and all info types, right? In training, we will teach you how to create those action. You will be able to see that front end, you will configure and that data will be come, that configuration will be come as a front end so that end user can use. Every configuration has an output. So whatever the configuration will do, you will be able to see the output as you have already end user experience, so you can make out like, oh, this info type has a lot of this option, how these options are coming. So all this in the realization phase is a configuration only. So I'll be teaching you that whole methodology, whole life cycle. That is the only benefit to go with this kind of institute. Otherwise, for the theory, if you do only you want to do, then go for the certification. There you will get only the theory part, not SAP practical thing.
Okay.
Getting my point. So I'll be sharing some sample details with you. I'll may not share that live data with you, but I'll guide you on all the live scenarios only. Okay, and you can also tell me like, okay, in your company you have this scenario. So how to meet that scenario in this system on that that server which will work on SAP. You can also do that. I'm sure you, in your life cycle, in SAP life cycle, you have worked on 800 client for the practice purpose. IDAS system. Because we generally give that for the you know, practice purpose to all the end users, so that they can practice IDAS system. The same SAP server you will get here. Venky will provide you a server, so you can do the practice n number of hours. There is no limitation. Till the time the course is there, you can do the practice.
Okay.
Any other doubt? This course is practical. Time management, take care of a leave for places. So you, I'll teach you how to configure the holiday calendar, how to create shifts, any of the shifts. You tell me the timing, I'll create the shift. And also, you'll do the practice for the same. That absences quota, I'm talking about it. So you also will create that casual leave quota, or any of one quota we will create. I'll create one, you also will create one and show me. Getting my point? So it's all practical only, nothing you know, only on the lecture. We'll do everything practical. After the practical, I'll give you the theory. Every after finishing of one module, I'll give you the theory part, and no need to note down anything. I have all the navigation step by step, so which I'll share with you. So just you need to understand the concept of SAP. But I'm teaching you, I'll already give you.
Okay, and what are the preparations you are asking from my end?
Nothing. What we will do the practical, the same you have to repeat, so that you can also do the same. See, I'm a consultant, tomorrow you will be going to the consultant. So what I have, that same knowledge I'll pass to you, and you also have to do the same thing. Getting my point?
Yes.
So that is the only expectation from SAP, from everyone. That they should be able to follow our practices, SAP practices, and do the same thing. All the PPTs I have, one by step, so no need to note down anything. Theory part also I have, which maybe you can have in your blueprint, business blueprint you can have. If you saw your company's business blueprint, the same documents like a theory part, we will cut it down and kept in one you know, file. So that same I'll share with you.
Okay. Is it possible to learn personal administration and payroll?
We will to teach you all, no, organizational management, recruitment, personal administration, time management, and payroll. These five modules we are going to teach you. But in case tomorrow you don't want to learn payroll, and you want, instead of a payroll, you would like to add personal development. So that I gave you option that you can do it.
Okay, in fact, my area is in payroll. My specialization
fine.
Is in
we'll go, we'll definitely that one by one, step by step, we'll do that payroll also. Like I cannot start initially payroll, I have to go for a you know, organizational management, then personal administration, then time management, and then payroll.
And what about ESS and MSS?
ESS MSS has a different you know, course curriculum. That's always different. That we will not accommodate. Only these five modules we will accommodate.
Okay, and one more question. Suppose if I want to move to SAP HR as my competency, then what should
see after doing this course? You can join any consultancy. There's no point of second question, because I'm gonna teach you that consultant knowledge only. I'm a consultant, though I'm working on a manager position, but I'm also a consultant. I'm a techno-functional consultant. I have the knowledge of SAP HR, ABAP HR, a little bit of basis and BIA as well.
Okay.
But my primary is SAP HR.
Okay. All right.
Yeah, Suresh and Paul, you have any doubts? Suresh?
Hi Jital, this is Suresh.
Yeah, Suresh.
Yeah, hi Suresh. Now I can at least hear your voice. Any doubts, Suresh?
That's what only, even that you were telling about five modules. Regarding this, you are telling about nobody is not. I mean, regarding this, there is no point to have nobody have all the modules experience. And what my doubt is regarding how to choose the modules before going ahead.
According to your interest and according to market interest, right?
See,
Like
you,
now,
my
if
interest
you
is
don't have a
something, and
specific requirement of SAP,
so why? Because even
see,
that,
maybe you don't have a
you
particular. No,
yeah,
let me
you just go ahead.
finish first. Maybe you don't have a particular choice, right? I want to go for a time management, or I want to go for a payroll. See, payroll is difficult. After learning this SPHR code, if you would like to apply for a payroll, that is impossible because that there we need actual experience and we can catch. In dummy system, we cannot run the payroll. You can do the configuration, you can see the output, like whatever the component you'll create, that is coming in the basic salary, or it is coming in the gross, or it is coming in the deduction, all the PF, ESI, all the taxation things, you can see the output, but you cannot run the payroll in this dummy system. So that payroll module, you cannot, after doing this, can apply for a job. But apart from that, you can tell that you have the configuration experience and other modules experience. You can see the output very nicely. There is a no doubt on that. But maybe see, you can go for a Naukri.com, Dice.com, or the job portal. First three module is compulsory for all the consultant. After that, you can see what is there in the market. Maybe people are asking travel management, or people are asking personal development, so that you can take after the PA module, you take that module. If you are applying in India, you choose other modules. If you are applying in abroad, then after the completion of a third module, start posting your resume in the portals and face the interviews. I'll guide you in the resume part. I'll guide you in the interview questions part as well. I am gonna take care of your technical round interview. Means whatever SAP related technical question will be there, or interview will be there, I'll take care about that. So
Okay,
after
and
doing this course, you can apply as a consultant, associate consultant, or a senior consultant.
okay, that's great. And one more thing is, and regarding this, I'm basically from recruitment background. And what I'm thinking is regarding this, if I'm going for basic module, if I'm going to learn this initial, you were telling about first three modules is mandatory, right? Right. After that, if I'm
People
going for
in
this.
the market, personal administration, specialized people.
Okay, and
If you will
that
apply in any channel partner, they'll take you as a specialized PA module consultant only.
sounds good. Okay, that sounds good. And
So,
regarding
if
this,
you are
would
into a
you?
recruitment, I'll suggest you PA module. If you are
Okay,
into a
and
recruitment, I'll suggest you to go for a PA module, because recruitment module doesn't have that much of job scope, because the person who's knowing that PA module can handle recruitment module as well, because the configuration part is almost the same. Recruitment has that 30% configuration. That same 30% configuration is there in the PM module, if the PM module is of 100%. So it is somewhere the common. So we don't have as much scope of a recruitment module. So you can go for a personal administration module specialization. In that, we teach some technical part also to give a boost in your resume, because I have a BAPHR experience as well. So I'll give some configuration, some technical knowledge as well as to you, so that whatever the dependency from a technical side is there, so that will not be in your case. So some boost will be there in your resume to highlight. And
getting
after
up.
finishing your PA module, you can apply for you post it as your resume. After that, you see, like, once you'll complete time management, update your resume. Anytime you can do that. See your interest as well, how much you are comfortable in that module. It's really easy, easy to learn, easy to obtain, easy to defend as well. So there is no, because it's, if I can do, you can also do the same.
Okay,
Any other
thank you.
question?
Apart from nothing else.
Okay, thank you. वेंकी,
हेलो या हेलो
शीतल,
पॉल,
आई हैव वन मोर
डू यू हैव
क्वेश्चन.
एनी डाउट्स?
या प्लीज.
या पॉल, पॉल यू कैन आस्क इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट्स.
या यू कैन हियर मी?
आई थिंक योर वॉल्यूम इज वेरी लो. या नाउ ओके.
ओके. हाय शीतल.
Yeah, hi Paul.
Yeah, so Sheetal, you said you're going to teach five modules, five basic modules, right?
Huh.
So,
This is a
but
basic mod. It is not a basic module. This is a main module. At least every company will have this much. Apart from this, there is no compulsion of the companies that they should go for a personal development. They should go for a travel management. Those called advanced module. But this model will be there with every company. If they have a CPHR.
okay, so out of these five, we have to be specialized in one module. That's what you said, right?
After PM module, you can choose, like, you can show your specialization in PM module, or you can show the specialization in time management or in the payroll. Any of the module you have to choose, or you can go for OM recruitment, PM, time, and knowledge of payroll. That's what my, students does. They show, let the interviewer decide that in which module he want to take you. Because anyways, I'm gonna teach you all the modules. You can tell you have the knowledge of payroll module as well. You have done all these things. Whatever you'll mention in your resume, accordingly they'll ask you the questions. So let them decide in which module they want to take you.
So once we complete this course, so we'll be specialized with five modules.
Yes.
Okay. And
Yeah, right. Yeah, but
one more question, like e-recruitment. There's a different model, right? E-recruitment.
yeah, for this
So.
the, for that we have a different course curriculum. That
Okay,
because that is
because
a portal related module.
because I have around 7 years experience in recruiting, field, ES recruiting. So I'm really not sure. I mean, which one is suitable for me? So in that, at that point, I mean, in that case, would you be able to advise me to
E-recruitment
choose?
is not having much scope because recruitment doesn't have much scope because once you have done, it's done. So there is no much scope in that. But if you would like to go for that, we have a separate course curriculum, separate trainer for that.
I mean, does it
Because that
require
is
any
portal
technical?
related. That it's required technical. In HR, we don't this all these module we don't require any HR, any technical knowledge of yours, any computer knowledge of yours.
Oh, okay.
I'll guide you how to create documents, how to create presentation. I may give you some samples as well, so that you can carry those documents with you for the future reference.
Yeah, because my educational background is I've done my BCom and I'm about to finish my MBA. So by the time I finish my MBA, I would like to learn this SAP HR. So is it suitable for me, or
Yeah,
do I
dear.
have
Even
to?
I'm a commerce graduate. I'm non-technical, but I'm taking care of a technical part, a technical module of SAP as well. SAP is really easy to learn and easy to maintain. That's why we are teaching you. Otherwise, see, tomorrow I'll share my my employment details also with you so that you can show as a reference in your resume. So why I'll do that if I'll not be able to teach you correct thing.
So every day we'll be having 1 hour class, right? Online?
According to your need, because my shift is a UK shift, 2 to 11 PM it is. So generally I'm taking session till 12, but I can alter it. I want to be finished by 1 o'clock maximum, so that I can reach to my office on time.
Yeah, Paul, I will tell you the timings and everything. I will inform you.
Sure.
Okay? Yeah, right. Yeah, Praveen, I think you said you have one more doubt.
You have one course in SAP Talent Management. What is the difference between talent management and personal administration?
It is, yeah, both of the different. they have different qualification skills and all in that. Here in the personnel and administration we have hiring till rehiring.
In talent management.
In that qualification skills and all comes into that. That see this presentation I've created for the some corporate. So I'm just offering only 5 modules to you in it. But you can alter, you can tailor your course curriculum. Like instead of a payroll, you can go for that module.
Okay.
You see what is there in the market. If you would like to go for a, you know, market consultant, you would like to apply as a consultant. So see what is there in demand. Maybe with PA, they want PD module, the personal development. So do that. If they need PA with travel management, then do that. We can anytime tell her. After completion of a third module, you should update your resume. I'll guide you, I'll give you the sample resume and all. You update your resume and post it in the market and start facing interviews along with the training only.
Okay.
That's how we should go. After completion of the course, then you'll prepare resume, then you'll prepare theory and then you will apply. So that is a like long journey then.
I understand.
Any other doubts?
Any doubts?
Yeah, Sheetal.
Yeah, Vicky.
Yeah, Sheetal, I mean, is there any way like we can choose 5 modules of our choice or?
No, dear. 3 modules is compulsory. Every consultant has to, and without that 3 modules, I cannot start things in SAP. I need to have employee in the system, then only I can go for his, you know, time data updation or his payroll data updation or his PD data updation. So I have to have that PA module in the system. After that, you can choose. See, we will see in the market, like if you are maybe in the Pune side and in the Pune, see what is there in the demand. Generally, you should go for the time management and the payroll because this model will be there with every company if they have a SAP. So apart from this, like a time management, you don't want to go for, you want to go for a you know, PD module. So I can take that module as well. Instead of a time management, we'll go for that. So we will see, like once you'll finish your third module, what is there in demand.
Okay, got it.
Generally, people do like instead of a payroll, they'll go for a, you know, PD module or they'll add benefit module like that.
Yeah.
Though one cannot do everything, so you have to see that part also, know how much you can digest.
Yes.
Maybe you don't require to do that only after doing the third module and posting the resume in the market, you will get a job.
Okay.
People from overseas done that a lot to me, that did not finish the last module only.
Thank you, Shita.
Oh, okay, fine.
Yeah. Okay.
Thank you, Becky.
Yeah, okay.
Thank you, everyone.
Okay. Yeah, thank you for attending demo class. I will let you know the timings, class timings, and everything. I will inform you. Okay.
Thanks, everyone.
Okay. Thank you for everyone. Okay. Thank you. Bye.
Bye.
Yeah. Bye.
The organizer has ended the session, and this.